Hello everyone, I'm back with another project. Today's project is a name sign that was designed by Steve Good. And for those of you that have been scrolling for a while, have heard of Steve Good and maybe have subscribed to his blog. And those of you that haven't subscribed yet and are newcomers, I highly recommend you get out there and subscribe. A lot of good information there at Steve's blog. He's been doing it for quite some time. A lot of free patterns, tutorials. He's got a lot of videos out there on how to use certain tools, blades, you name it. But I would get out there and subscribe ASAP. A lot of good stuff. What I'll do is I'll put the link to his blog in the description at the end of this video. It's scrosawworkshop.blogspot.com. And it'll be at the end of my my video here in the description. So anyways, with that being said, what I'm doing today, this pattern that he designed, he requires two pieces of wood to be used. Quarter-inch material for the top piece, which is what you see here. And it also allows you to put a name in here. He also has like a template for each a pattern for each letter of the alphabet, so you can go in there and you can select which one you need. The other thing is with the pattern, he also has a pattern for a backer board that goes on the back of this for contrast purposes. What I'm going to do today is I'm not going to be using a scroll saw to cut this out. I'm going to be using a 3/4 inch piece of pine board that's about 17 by 9 inches. What I'm going to do is I'm going to be using a plunge router and a combination of 3.175 millimeter CNC bits, which I have here, and end milling bits. Okay, end milling bits. What I did here is I actually traced it out with carbon paper onto this wood here. In the areas that I'm going to be removing, I shaded them out. So let me explain to you. I'm going to be using this CNC bit right here. There's like four different sizes. I believe this one is a 10 degree CNC bit. And I'm going to go around and I'm going to trace all these lines here around the lettering, around the design here. And I'm going to go down probably the thickness of the shaft. As you can see here, it's about 1/8 of an inch. And it's probably a good idea before you do this, if you attempt this type of sign or do this, is get a scrap piece of wood and practice on it and figure out what depth you want. And then once you do have that depth, it'd be easier to adjust or to set your milling bit, okay? Because you're going to be using this milling bit to do all this clean out, all these gray areas here, okay? So just get a piece of scrap wood and, you know, do a little practice getting your depth. Once you get it, and you'll be fine. This way you don't make any mistakes when you go to do the clean out. You'll have the same depth, okay? So that's what I'm going to do first, and I'll explain as we go along with this project. So I'll be using my Dremel plunge router. I do have a 1/4 inch router, and I may use that because it uses the 1/4 inch. There's a 1/4 inch bit for these bigger pieces in through here, but I might be able to just use the Dremel plunge router. I'll be able to use that. That'll work fine. So anyways, with that being said, let's get going on this project. Thank you. right. I'm back. Went around with a CNC bit. Went around all these lines here. Went down about an eighth of an inch. As you can see up here, did a little practice spot here and got my depth. So now when I do all the clean out, I'll use it as kind of a guide to set my depth with my milling bit to do all the clean out here in the gray areas. Some of the areas, well, like with the straight lines and everything, some areas didn't come out too straight, but I'll be able to clean that out and fix that as I go along with sandpaper and maybe with the milling bit a little bit, I'll be able to straighten out some of the areas. But all in all, not too bad. Should come out pretty good. So with that being said, let's get to the next segment in this video. Be right back. This all cleaned out with the milling bit. All these gray areas are all removed. I'm happy the way it came out. And I know I mentioned the last segment in this video that some of the areas with the CNC bit didn't come out too straight, and I would have to go around with an engraving bit and smooth out these areas and straighten them out. But what I found is that when I started doing the clean out, I was able to actually was able to straighten them out with the milling bit. So it worked out fine for me and saved me some time. And any other areas that seemed like they needed some touch up, being smoothed out or whatever, I just went around with some sandpaper. All these areas in here, these straight lines, the curved marks here, and then I also went over with this needle file. And went around all these areas here. You'd be surprised after using a milling bit, there'll be some pieces of wood that'll be stuck here. And it seemed like this needle file was able to knock them off. So along with the needle file and the sandpaper, it worked out fine as far as cleaning this up and everything. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to be using this engraving bit with the flex shaft. And I'm going to go around and texture all these areas that I cleaned out. And I think it's going to look good. It'll give it a nice look. It's going to take me some time, but I think it'll work out. And after I get done doing that, I'm going to be painting this black, these areas that I removed with some acrylic black paint. But I'll explain that when I return. So I went around all these areas that I cleaned out with the engraving bit. And I textured all these areas here. Took me a little while to do. But I took my time, went around with this engraving bit and made all these little divots. And the reason why I did that is because after this it gets finished off with a couple coats of the clear gloss, gives it kind of a sparkling look, and I kind of like that. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to give this a couple coats of this clear gloss spray. And not for finishing purposes. The reason why I'm doing it is because I want to seal in all these areas here that I cleaned out and I texturized. The purpose for that, and the reason why I'm doing the purpose is because I'm going to use this black acrylic paint and I'm going to water it down just a little bit. And I'm going to paint all these areas in here. And if I don't seal it with this clear coat, what's going to happen is the paint's going to bleed into the lettering and in this design there. And I don't want that to happen. So what I'm going to do is give it a couple coats of this. And once it dries, I'll start painting with this black acrylic paint. Don't have to be really careful getting it onto the lettering and the design part, because I'll be sanding that off of my mouse sander, and I'll explain that later. And by the way, this spray finish here, this spray poly, you can get this at any big box store, either Walmart, Home Depot, Lowe's. And this acrylic paint, I purchased this at Walmart. I think it was like $1. And the acrylic spray, I think it was $3, so it's not too bad. But you can get this at Walmart or Hobby Lobby. So we'll get going on the clear coat, and then I'll come back and start painting with the black paint. I got this painted with the black acrylic paint. I thinned it out a little bit, and it worked out pretty good. I got all these areas in here, all the clean out, the spots that I texturized with the carving bit. It dropped in there, and it covered pretty good. I only had to touch up a few spots. But one mistake I made here, when I went to paint this, I painted past the outside line here of the pattern, and I covered it up, and I should have probably cut this out on the scroll saw first before I painted this. So what I had to do, I had to go around the edges after this dried and sand it by hand to see if I could pick up some of the lines of the pattern when I traced it on here, and I was able to do that, and I was able to reapply the pattern and with the carbon paper and retrace it. So I'll be all right with that. So luckily I was able to save this project. But anyways, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring this over to the scroll saw and cut this out. I'm going to be using a number 7 Pegas double skip tooth blade. And I'm going to be cutting this out, the perimeter of this. And then I'll bring it back over and gonna sand it with the Mega mouse sander and sand this down, and hopefully I put enough of the clear coat on here to seal up the areas here, and hopefully none of the paint bled into the lettering and the design of the sign. So we'll get over to the scroll saw, cut it out, and we'll sand it down with the Mega mouse sander, and we'll see what we get. Be right back. Thank you. Got the sign all cut out over by the scroll saw. Use the number 7 double skip tooth blade, Pegas scroll saw blade. I got this all cut out. Came out pretty good. Then I brought it over to the mouse sander. Started sanding off these areas here and noticed that the sandpaper needed to be changed. So I had to stop the video and change the sandpaper, and then continue on. And came off pretty good. The clear finish that I put on here, the seal, before I painted, looked like it worked out. There was no bleed through the design work or the lettering here. So I'm happy with that. So the next step is gonna be, I'm gonna use this boiled linseed oil. I'm gonna go over all this lettering and this design part here. Maybe one or two coats. It'll give it kind of a, like a yellowish amber look, which I think will look nice. And then after that dries real good, I'm gonna give it a couple coats, maybe two or three coats of this semi-gloss clear Rust-Oleum. This really works good. Covers good, leaves it with a real nice shine. You can buy this at Lowe's for about $3. I bought this a while ago at Lowe's also, about $25, $25, $30. This will last me quite a while. So, once all this dries really good and it's all finished up, I'm going to use these eye hooks. I'm going to put one on each side. Get a couple chains so it can be hung up somewhere. And you don't necessarily have to use the chains. You could put a hanger on the back of it and hang it on the wall. That'll also work pretty good too. So there's a couple options there. So let's get this finished off and see where we're at. Finish this off with about four coats of that semi-gloss. Really smooth, really shiny. Sparkles in these areas here that I mentioned, you know, when I did the texture. Kind of gives it like a sparkling effect. Really comes out nice. Like I said, this product's really good. You can get it at Lowe's or Home Depot. It's not really expensive, about $3, like I mentioned. So, yeah, check it out. Also, in my description, I'll have the link to these CNC bits and the milling bits. So, if you're interested, just check them out. They're really not that expensive. They really work well. So, with that being said, this Chacon sign is done. So, if you like you like the video, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, leave any comments below. Thanks for watching.